welcome to FYE channel. FYE stands for your entertainment. Mapapanood ninyo ang iba't ibang Kumu native content mula sa ANCX, Mix, ABS-CBN Books, Metro Jitney, GPTV, Cinema One, at ABS-CBN Sports. Kaya marami kayong dapat abangan mula Lunes hanggang Linggo. So, my name is, hi MK Hernandez and Alvin. My name is Marian Mencias. I have an upcoming book with ABS-CBN Books, Pose. Hi Mary Chris Ferreras. And the book's title is very interesting. Marami ba dyang single? Marami ba dyang single? I wanna know. Because single and frustrated dahil dumating si COVID bago umaksyon si Cupid. Anyway, the title of my upcoming book is Lord, anong petsa na? Bakit wala pa siya? Nakarelate pa kayo? Lord, anong petsa na? Ba't wala pa siya? Ano ba yan? Yun, they're still single. Hashtag siya. Shay Shay Jen. Okay, thank you for appreciating the title. So, ang topic natin tonight ay okay, dati stress din ako sa pagiging single. So, gets na gets ko kayo. Pero, masaya ang topic natin tonight because it's all about how to enjoy being single. What are the perks of being single? How to enjoy the singlehood? Kasi dati, okay, pwede ko ba kayong kwentuhan? Okay, kasi dati, I used to be this girl who is so hungry for love. Yes, gutom sa pag-ibig. Nag-dinner na ba kayo? Ayan, gutom ako sa pag-ibig. So, I was settling for the wrong relationships. Ayan na! Meron dyan siguro sa inyo, single. Pero, you are settling for a complicated relationship or for a... Oh! Claire Prima is with us. Prima Clara, hello, my friend. O, diba ang aking superstar friend is here. Okay, so, I was really hungry for love and I was settling for relationships na alam kong at the onset mali na, 'di ba? May mga relasyon tayong ganyan. Alam natin sa simula pa lang mali na. Oy, maganda daw kung meron tayong background music. Meron ba diyan magpapa-background music? Okay, sabi ng aking expert friend in Kumu. Okay, I used to be with someone who has a wife. Tignan mo, they were married for about 3 years. Oh. So minsan kasi akala natin sasaya tayo. Kasi lahat tayo, create tayo to love and be loved. Ngunit datapwat bagkus. Minsan, yung pagmamahal na yon ay mali. Kaya nga gustong-gusto ko yung sinabi ni Mav Gonzalez. Sabi niya, mabuti nang wala kesa mali. Mabuti nang wala kesa mali. O diba? Sometimes it will quench your thirst for love, but then eventually, it will make you very miserable. So, kailangan, pag nag-i-invest tayo sa pag-ibig, yun yung type ng pag-ibig na long-term. Hindi yung short-term, masaya ka, long-term-wise, miserable ka. Diba? Ang dami mong sinayang na oras, ang dami mong sinayang na energy, panahon, pera, yun pala, mali. And you know, I always mention in my talks, sometimes, no, the devil's most powerful scheme is to make us fall in love with the wrong person at the wrong time for the wrong reasons while you are still the wrong person. So sometimes the devil's most, actually often nga yan eh, the devil's most powerful scheme is to make you fall in love with the wrong person at the wrong time for the wrong reasons while you are still the wrong person. Kasi na-realize ko, kaya pala ako ganun because I had a father wound. Di ko alam kung kayo, may mga wounds din kayo from... Hi, Thomas! Hi, Johnny! high itay, so may mga wounds din from parents. Actually, usually naman, di ba, meron tayo nun. And it's never to hate them, to blame them, kasi hindi natin alam na sila, marami rin silang pinagdaanan na masakit in their own lives. So, ang kailangan natin iwasan is ang paulit-ulit na kasalanan or paulit-ulit na misery. Kunwari, yung lolo, lasinggero. Diba, kunwari? Thank you naman po sa pa-welcome. Or Y-L-A-P-N. Hi, Charm. Kunwari, yung lolo, lasinggero. Tapos, yung anak niya, ganun din. Tapos, ikaw, feeling mo, you're also very much inclined to alcohol. Diba? So, kailangan, yung mga sugat natin sa puso, kailangan muna nun mahilom. Kasi pag hindi yun nahilom at tumalon tayo sa relationship after relationship, then, what's gonna happen is, we're just going to be miserable and our children will also be miserable. Sabi nga nila, 60% of children who grew up in abuse homes actually ended up also marrying an abusive spouse. So, o diba, i-corona tayo. Thank you, Claire. So, hi, Ina! Thank you for being here, guys. So, yon. So, kailangan ingatan ang ating puso. Okay, hindi pwedeng masaya lang ngayon. Bukas, iiyak-iyak na tayo. Kasi ikaw ay very precious, single ladies in the house, and even dun sa mga may relasyon na dyan, siguraduhin natin na inaalagaan natin ang puso natin. Kasi alam nyo, pag hindi nyo inaalagaan yung puso nyo, paano mo expect another person to take good care of your heart? Eh makikita niya, ay, wala naman siyang pakialam sa puso niya eh. Bakit ko aalagaan, di ba? Okay lang naman sa kanyang ginagamit ko siya eh. Di sige, nagpapagamit. You know, I do interviews with real men. And one, kung kilala niyo yung Boiling Waters, in-interview ko sila. At sabi nila, yung mga babae na, ginost na sila. Tapos, umalis na yung lalaki. After a year, bumalik sila. Game pa rin si sister, game pa rin yung girl. So, ang ginawa nila, okay, game ka pa din. Sige, gagamitin pa rin kita. Pero, after nun, ginost siya ulit, diba? So, binasag ka na, mas babasagin ka pa. Kasi ikaw mismo, hindi mo inaalagaan ang iyong puso. Okay, so we're gonna talk more about this in the coming weeks. Pero ngayon, I have a special guest with us. Yeah, marurupok tayo. So, kailangan natin mag-practice na hindi maging marupok, but maruproof. Maruproof, not marupok. Okay, so let us welcome with us. There. Wait. Ayan. This is exciting. Kasi meron tayong makakasama tonight. And I will just briefly introduce her. Her name is... Ayan. Hi, Nerva! You look so beautiful tonight. Okay. I-introduce lang kita konti sa kanila. So Zara Louise, her name is as pretty as her face, is the co-founder, artist, and writer behind the platform Love and Light Company. She is a creative spirit at the very core. Yeah, kailangan mahanap mo talaga muna yung sarili mo eh, bago ka maghanap ng lover. Di ba, Zara? Dedicated to being a vessel to create things that add value to other people's experience of life. She is a fervent believer in deep empathy, generous doses of humor, and persistent prayer. Ayan, pareho kami ng paniniwala. Okay, so let us all welcome Zara! Yay! Okay, mag-earphones ako. Sana gumana. Kasi kanina iwan ko ba dito? Hindi gumagana. Okay, hi Zara! How are you?
Well,
kumusta ka tonight?
I hear you well.
Ah, medyo mahina. Hey, Kuy! Tumas yung boses. Hey, Kuy! Oh, ang galaw po, Ma'am Zara. Ikaw hard, Zani. Mo sa akin sinabi yan.
Oh, thank you. What if I just hold my phone? Can you hear me?
Yes, better? There. I can hear you clearly. Perfect.
Okay. So, okay. Thank you for the very generous introduction. So,
Of
as you were
course.
saying, catch up muna tayo. How are you? How are you doing in the midst of this pandemic, unprecedented times?
Okay naman ako. Syempre, there are a lot of things happening that are heartbreaking, pero I just thank God that, you know, I know my calling, I know my purpose. And so, this time is still, ano, very much life-giving. Syempre, not without any challenges. Pero marami, marami pa rin blessings na dumarating. Ikaw, Zara, how are you?
I think I'm doing well. I think we're all coping up. We're all coping in our own ways. Lately, I've been thinking na in this pandemic, marami tayong unprocessed emotions, but we're just really hoping and still striving to be better every day. But for those who are watching, I want you to know that even though, you know,
we're trying to
like really kayanin yung mga nangyayari, and we're expecting more and more of ourselves every day, it's okay to take a break, process
yes.
and just keep on hoping. Also, Martin, I really like the things you said earlier, but I wish I could butt in much earlier. Like, yes, sister. So I really liked what you said about healing your inner child, because
yes.
No, it's an important thing to heal your thought patterns, your feeling patterns. I also liked what you said about guarding your heart. The Bible says that very often, to guard your heart and guard your thoughts, because, you know, dun nanggagaling lahat, our values, our foundations, what kind
Correct.
Of relationship are we okay with, what kind of treatment do we tolerate in our lives. So, yeah.
Yes. So guarding our hearts is really crucial, especially this time, di ba? Kasi yung mga stuck lang at home, parang lalo kang nagiging marupok kasi mas nafe-feel mo yung loneliness. Pero all the more because you quoted the Bible, all the more we need our solid relationship with someone who will never fail us, who really loves us. Kasi nung hindi ko pa kilala si God, ay, nako naman. Actually, kilala ko na siya, pero ako lang lagi nasusunod. Okay, Lord, guwapo siya. G! Ganon. Pero ngayon, Lord, type ko to. Type mo ba siya for me? And because of that, mas nasa-save ako. Ano na?
Discernment.
Discernment, yes. Mas nasa-save ako from the wrong people. Actually, Zara, one time, I was talking with this girl. Tapos, parang, pareho kami actually ng story, pero sabi niya, hindi ganun ka strong yung hindi siya masyado nagsispend ng time with the Lord, ganyan. So, parehong-pareho kami ng kind of guy na na-fall in love with.
Yeah.
Tapos, I just felt, kasi sila, naging sila. Kami, even before naging kami, nakita ko na, oh my gosh, this is wrong. So sabi niya, sana daw, mas nakinig siya ng mas maaga para hindi siya mas nadurog. So,
alam mo yun, parang these desires, you know, wanting to be loved, wanting to be desired, wanting to give love, those are God-given naman. But, you know, like you said earlier, it's the devil's way sometimes to get to us by manipulating those desires. We start wanting the wrong things. But,
yes.
You know, soundboard with God, we get to ask Him, Lord, parehas ba kami ng values? Does this person mm-hmm. live kindness? Alam mo, sa panahon ngayon, like you said, maraming stuck at home. Ang dami kong nababasang memes and conversation online about falling in love sa mga ka-chat. Sa
yeah,
mga,
oh, yes.
Kahit hindi mo nakikita. So, you know what? If you are going to admire someone or be in a relationship with someone, you have to be with someone na napanood mo na how he deals with life. Anong
tama
character?
Yun.
Paano
yes.
siya mag- failures, with suffering, how does he deal with arguments, how is he with his family?
Diba si Ina, Quarren Flings! Oh my golly! Quarren Flings! I love that term!
Yeah, and if you're in a relationship right now in this pandemic and you have a strong foundation, you still extend kindness to one another during this time, it will still, you know, flow smoothly. Hopefully,
yes.
forever.
Kasi kailangan talaga alam mo yung values mo, kailangan kilala mo yung sarili mo. If there is one order that I share with people, it's really master, mission, mate. Master, mission, mate. Kasi marami kayong dadaanan sa relationship na, ah, di ko na kaya, bakit ba ito? Akala ko mahal ko siya, akala ko perfect siya, bakit? bakit nung mag-asawa na kami, hi, monster! Diba? So it's very important that also, you know your values, sabi mo nga, para match kayo ng values. And also, may master ka na sa life mo para alam mo na mahal ka ni God at hindi ka papasok sa isang relasyon para kumuha ng pagmamahal, pero para magbigay. Give and take, diba?
But it's clear, diba, your friend, nagkatuluyan sila ng person who is wrong for her.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Alam niyo ba, it's still possible to end up marrying the wrong person. Like, it's still possible. It happens. Sometimes people end up in marriages that are not for them. But that's just grace in our lives. Hindi kanya hayaang, alam mo yun, mag-end up in a chaos, in a mess. Even if you choose the wrong things, he will still redeem you in your darkest moments. But here's the scary thing.
Mm-hmm.
Only settle for God's grace or God's best. Kasi, alam mo yun, pilit mo yung mga bagay in your hands, you keep holding them in your hands. Hindi sila mapalitan ni God ng mga bagay na para sa'yo.
Correct. So, alam,
pipilit mo or isa-surrender mo na lang muna.
So, matagal ka na bang single, Zara?
Not really.
Ah! So, taken ka ba ngayon?
No, I'm single.
Ah, single ka ngayon. So, recently. Ay, naku, takal ko na single. Kinarir ko na yan.
Career na ito.
Career na ito. Career. It's a calling. Sana naman, Lord, meron tong ano, diba? May iba tayong pupunta. Tutulong lang tayo ng singles. Tapos, eventually, diba? Yeah. Tutulong naman tayo sa kanila pag married na rin tayo.
But you know, I think the problems these days is that people view singlehood as a problem. Like, this is a messed up face. I'm missing out on something.
Ay, nako, sinabi mo pa, mga pressure ng mga tito-tita, di ba?
Oo. Kasi lagi ka na magtatanong yan kapag nasa gatherings ka, oh, my boyfriend ka na ba? Kailan ka ikakasal? Ganyan, ganyan, ganyan. Pero,
lagi!
Oo, pero we forget sometimes na our standards shouldn't be based on other people's standards, not what we see on our timeline, not what we see on social media, hindi yung mga hashtag relationship goals. Those are not our standards in life. Our standards in life are determined by, you know, God's timeline. Parang kung ano yung tama para sa atin, because we have different processes, different stages. So,
we need to
pattern yung life natin.
Correct.
And based on other people or pressure from our titas and titos.
Buti ka pa, alam mo na yan. Bata ka pa. Sana alam ko na to dati pa. Di sana dami kong mga mistakes na naiwasan. But, at least...
Super naman, very beautiful and youthful.
Ha? Ay, nako. So, very important nga that we realize that we all have a different timeline. Na huwag tayo magkumpara-kumpara ng lives natin with other people. And also... you know, pray for the grace to be happy for them. And if you are still single, it just means that God has a great adventure pa for you. Dati, really, gusto ko lagi may relationship, yun pala, magsusulat ako ng books, etc., etc. So, sabi ko, oh my God! Ang dami kong namin miss out kasi masyado kong hungry for ano nun. For attention, for love. Ang dami pa palang masaya. Sobrang importante ng single season, don't you think, Zara?
Yeah, it's not a season of anyway, you're missing out on something. Instead, look at it this way. Parang when you're single, it's not time to mope around. It's not a waiting season even.
Yes.
Think about that. It's not a waiting season. It's your time. If you really think of your time as something that is God-given, you will get to ask the question, Lord, what can I do with this time? Ang daming problema sa mundo. Parang you can use it to serve. You can use it to better yourself. Parang kasi nga na singlehood is a time to be selfish, ganyan, to have fun. Pero for me, it's just a bonus. How, alam mo yun, parang when you meet God one day and He asks you, what did you do with your time when you were still single? Parang, anong sasabihin mo? Wala lang. Nakipag-chat ako sa, ano, parang, another. But here's the thing. We do those things. Like you said, we have desires. We want affection. We want attention. But when we surrender those to God, He'll replace those desires with healthy ones. Kasi, eto ha, I think this is very important. No relationship can cure your insecurities. No relationship can remedy the problems of your heart. A relationship
So
is not
true.
medication for our personal issues. So hindi natin ginagamit yung ibang tao, hindi natin ginagamit yung relationships to cure ourselves.
Yes,
But
actually, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. But when we join together another person and we know the fullness of God and can put God in the center, alam mo yun, mas may path, mas may purpose. Hindi siya yung...
Exactly.
One of my favorite quotes is that love does not consist of gazing at each other, but looking at a similar direction outwardly together. So, alam, ayaw niyo pa ng relationship na purposeful, a relationship where you can dream together kesa yung obsessively just looking at each other all the time.
Yes, exactly. Tsaka, I've been, sabi nila, Zara, very well said. And I've learned from happily married couples na your partner in life will only give you 30% happiness. Yun lang yung masasatisfy niya sa'yo. So 70% will come from your girlfriends, from your other friends, from your purpose, from your relationship with God, from your relationship with yourself. So if you think that a relationship is a solution to your loneliness, it will not be. Kasi when we are married, it will magnify. Kunyari, lonely ka na single, if you find a partner, eventually, mamamagnify yung loneliness mo. So if you are if you are toxic as a single person, then your relationship will eventually be toxic. At kawawa rin yung mga kids, di ba? Kapag ganun yung... yung nangyari. So we really have a responsibility as single people to really enjoy the season and to really grow and know what real love is. First for ourselves. Kailangan alam mo kung paano, alam mo yung boundaries mo. Kasi Zara, yung iba, kaya sila nauuwi sa mga, hey Clarice, hi Anthony, kaya sila nauuwi sa mga relationship na mali. Kasi wala nang boundaries. Kunyari, kakakilala lang, kakausapin na dahil kilig na kilig. Kakausapin na hanggang madaling araw, wala nang limit, hanggang 2 a.m. Ang treatment na, para na siyang girlfriend, sinabi niya na yung buong buhay niya, ready na siyang pakasalan. And then, eventually, hindi naman pala, yung guy is, ang dami palang kausap na girls, di ba? And I learned that from guys, they really, you know, talk to a lot of girls. Tapos, pili na lang sila. So, kapag hindi ka nila napili, at hindi dahil ano ka, alam mo yun, di lang din sila mature. Boys and not real men. Yun. So, durog na naman tayo.
Yeah, diba? What we tolerate in dating only multiplies in marriage. It doesn't get better just because you got married or the relationship extended for a long period of time. So, what you tolerate in dating or what you tolerate in those pre-relationship periods, those things will only multiply. So,
Yes. So it's important to know you are, if we want a healthy relationship, we have to be healthy first. Kasi marami dyan girls, maraming Mr. Wrong. Maraming Mr. Wrong. Dadalhin ka nila hindi sa ano. They will bring hell on earth for you, not heaven on earth.
You know, alam mo, minsan girls fall for this kind of pattern. We tend to even Christianize things. Like we say, okay, kahit hindi siya mabait, kahit hindi siya yung taong gusto ko, maybe he's here because I'm here to save him, or maybe I'm here because help him. Maybe it's my purpose to enlighten him. Girls, hindi natin trabaho yun. Like,
amen!
It's not your job to save him. Like, in our darkest moments, we can't even save ourselves. We can only be saved, really, through God's grace. And if you want that person to know God or parang, alam mo yun, be enlightened. Hindi mo trabaho na habul-habulin siya kahit iniiwan ka na niya, kahit pinagtutulakan ka na niya, kahit na hindi siya mabait sa'yo. Like, look, don't fall
hey,
in
Monica.
Love sa future potential. Like, parang, sometimes we just like people kasi parang, oh, I think in the future, pwede pa naman siya maging ganito. Or in the future, kapag natutunan niya to, pwede pa naman kaming maging ganito. Those are future potentials. You don't even see that those in the present, but look for evidences in their behavior. Ano ba
yes.
yung
Oh my gosh, you have so much wisdom. Do not look at supernatural signs. Parang, oh my gosh, bigyan niya ako ng red roses. Look at natural signs. Nirerespeto ba niya ang magulang niya? Responsable ba siya? Honest ba siya? Faithful ba siya? Nagiging mas mabuting tao ka ba with him? Or napapasama ka? My ex is choking. So yes, look at natural signs. Yes, saka alam mo.
Ko lang.
Alam mo, I think really God saves. Ang dami kong kilala right before their wedding, nakakakita na sila ng signs na, oh my gosh, meron siyang anger problem. Grabe yung mga salita niya sa akin. Oh my gosh, nasaktan na niya ako. Oh my gosh, niloko na niya ako. I know so many women who still go for it, who still proceed with the wedding. And I met this girl actually in particular. Sinabi niya, I was conducting a seminar. Tapos sabi niya, sabi ko, please continue the sentence. Marriage is, alam mo sagot niya? Sabi niya, marriage is agony. Oh my God, agony. Oh my God. So they were 10 years together with a guy, and then she found out the guy was cheating on her. She found out the guy was lying about his drinking. Pero sabi niya, first love ko to eh. So gusto ko yung first love ko, siya na mapangasawa ko. Yung mga ganong paniniwala. So eventually they got married. And during the time I met her, she said it was agony because the guy ended up cheating on her still several times. Binugbog siya. Tapos wala pang trabaho. So, you know, God will provide a way out. But it's still up to us if we will listen to Him trying to save us. Or tayo mismo ay papasukin pa rin natin yung relasyon na alam na natin. Kasi girls are given that God-given intuition eh, di ba? Oh, ang ganda ng through night and day, yes. Super
yes,
lucky.
Umiyak ko, like, hindi lang iyak, more like hagulgul. I watched it the other night. Nag-ugly cry ako. I'm super happy for letting everyone know about it. I agree ganda. With you. I want everyone to remember, not just because you spent so much time investing in a mistake, it doesn't mean kailangan mo siyang ipagpatuloy. It's never too late to be right, or it's never too late to make the right decision. Alam mo yun, it's gambling. Parang hindi ka na makaalis kasi ang dami mo nang pinusta. But
yes.
The more you go into it, the more you lose. And even if you acknowledge that, go ka pa rin. But it doesn't get better. We know that
it doesn't get better. Oh, tin mo si Inao endured it for 7 years. Oh, di ba?
Oh my
ako,
God.
Ako, eh. On and off 10 years.
Ouch.
Oh, di ba?
Yeah, pero it ended. Feeling ko, that's how you know then na, you know, God was able to reach your heart. Kasi hindi ka niya hinayang na ma-stuck in a relationship you don't belong.
Yes, o ito naman si Prima Clara, narinig niya sa Bible study. Nagpa-Bible study kami niyan together.
Like a small group ba tayo ngayon?
Parang, no? Ay, may nagtatanong. May nagta-issue po ba yung religion sa inyo? What if magkaiba kayo ng religion? To me, if it's very important to you, your faith, like for me, it's very important to me. So, para sa akin, mas maganda, mas madali for us and for the children. Kasi I feel marriage is hard already. So, in the things and the stuff that will make it easier for you guys, then make it easier. And pinaka makakapagpadali would be similar values, similar convictions.
Totoo. For me then, for me kasi, I'm a very faith-driven person. And like sinabi nga ni Marion, I've recently heard na a quote. It said that marriage sometimes is like 99 problems and there's like one reason to just move forward and you have to hold on to that. Minsan, that's faith. And minsan, in relationships, it's really sharing the same foundation, the same values. Kapag magulo na lahat, how do you deal with things? Like, how do you share the value of kindness, respect? You know, do you both take courage in the relationship? Mga ganon. Kasi mahirap pag hindi kayo parehas ng prinsipyo at mga paninindigan. So, it's just going to fall apart.
And, oh, si Johnny, my heart is crying. Hoo-hoo-hoo. Bakit naman your heart is crying?
Sorry, kami ba yung nagpaiyak sa heart mo?
Blessed are those who are able to endure pain and still love. Oo naman. It's really love. Love endures. Kaya lang naniniwala ako talaga, guys, that there are may mga pain in this world that are unnecessary. Yung kung hindi lang matigas ang ulo mo, hindi mo naman na kailangan pagdaanan. Yun. Yeah. Kung mas nakinig ka lang, mas na-spare yung heart mo.
True. It's better to be loved than not to be loved at all.
Aray ko po ang stream na to.
Well, pero...
Nakatawa kayo, guys. Ang saya.
May parang gusto ko mag-comment doon. It's better to be loved than not to be
go,
loved.
Go. Please, Sarah. Go ahead.
Pero what comment if it's the wrong love? Will you settle for that? Diba sabi sa ano, Perks of Being a Wallflower ba yun? Parang we settle for the kind of love we think we deserve. So if you think you deserve little, you're going to settle with little. And no one deserves little. I mean, my reminder to myself is that if someone like Jesus died for me, parang I don't deserve little. And,
amen.
Kumati, wag na lang. Diba? So,
yeah. Wag fake love, guys. Dun tayo sa real, true love. Kasi we are made for real love. Sabi nga dun sa isang book na nabasa ko, girls are made for a 7-course meal, but a lot of women settle for crumbs. They settle for junk food. And because they don't know that they are meant for a 7-course meal. Kasi maraming girls, diba, they have not seen how a woman should be properly treated. Di nila nakita yon. And a lot of...
tayong models, you're right.
Yeah, alam mo, they say na majority of the problems of this world, yung mga nagkakos ng crimes and all that, are actually rooted in fatherlessness. So it's very important women to choose the right person kasi we can choose our husbands, but our kids, our future children, cannot choose their dads. Yeah. And napakahirap magpalaki ng toddler na husband. You want to be a wife. You want to be a partner. You don't want an eldest child in a husband.
Ito. But it's one of the things that people also ask, no? We keep saying kanina pa na you have to settle for what you deserve, for what you think is, you know, match with your value. Pero ang hindi alam ng iba is where do I even start asking or knowing what my value is, what my worth is? Pero where do I begin measuring that? Where do I even begin trying to understand that? Kasi sometimes the answers we have are as good as the questions we ask. So we have to really understand that.
Mm-mm.
Ikaw, Marianne, how do you usually process that when somebody asks you, how do I determine my value? How do I determine my worth?
Well, kasi before nga, I didn't know my worth. So I would settle for relationships that are wrong for me. And definitely, I was also the wrong person. I was just in the relationship to get. And I am so happy that God saved me from that. And then I met Bo Sanchez. Mm-hmm. He's the founder of our community. So he went to our company to give a talk. And from there, parang biglang... I started reading spiritual books, and I had then a relationship na 10 years. So I really, that was the time when I took, my faith more seriously, and I asked God, Lord, gusto mo ba talaga siya for me? Kasi kung ayaw mo siya for me, I will let him go. And that's one of the hardest prayers
that
I've ever prayed. Pero when I let the guy go, and I let my other actions ko before that I know weren't pleasing to the Lord nung tinanggal ko yun sa life ko, biglang it gave birth to purpose, to more beautiful things. So people think that obeying the Lord is boring, he's such a killjoy, it's all no, don't do this, don't do that. But actually, it's not a world full of no's, it's actually a world filled with yeses. Yes to real adventure. Yes to your purpose. You know, it's so important that women, you know, alam mo yung purpose mo. Kasi sobrang hirap kapag may asawa ka na, may mga anak ka na, and sila lang yung magiging purpose mo. Kasi iba yung inspiration if makikita nila that you're living a full life. Kasi sila mismo, they would want to live a full life. And you are created not just to get married. You are here for beautiful reasons, your talents, your personality. Lahat yan, merong purpose for the world which will make you happy and fulfilled. So don't miss it. Find out what it is habang single ka pa. Iba na kasing responsibility.
I'm hoping around. Hadina, I'm not from CCF. I'm from Victory Church. I go to church in Alabang. Yon.
Oh, Victory ka pala. I love Catholic ako, so I attend both the feast.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. They're very similar, the songs, the messages. I used to attend, actually very instrumental sa akin ng CCF eh. Kasi I attended the big retreat. Our girly guys. Ang daming cute doon. Yun yung time na birthday ko at nag-break na kami ng ex ko. Tapos, yun, I went there and sabi ko, Lord, ikaw na muna ang date ko. Pero sabi ko, oh my gosh, distraction is real. Ang daming cute. Pero it's because of that retreat that made me fall in love with God's Word more. Kasi before, parang to me, the Bible is just a book with ancient readings.
Yeah.
Pero now, wow, it's so alive.
God is close to the brokenhearted.
So, oh, yon, yes. I was so brokenhearted that time.
Yeah, wag ka kayong magtaka kung in your like darkest moments, you feel this warmth and you just wanna, like, you know, cry it out to God. Like, when my like followers from Love and Light also ask kung, like, how do I find my worth? How do I find my value?
Yeah.
A lot of social media platforms right now and even public figures or influencers will lead you to self-love. Like, love yourself, celebrate yourself, ganyan, ganyan. It's not bad naman to appreciate yourself and acknowledge your skills, acknowledge your, you know, your talents, yourself, your personality. But for me, I always try to lead them back to God because He was the one who loved you at your darkest and hindi kanya iiwan until the very end. So, you know, if that kind of grace really envelops your life and really reaches out to you in the worst moments ever, kahit natalikuran mo siya, kahit naiwan mo siya, kahit tayo yung toxic sa kanya, sometimes he just never leaves. So, you know, you have this love that's just available for you all the time. So you don't have to, you know, pick up the crumbs and settle for less than what you're worth and settle for sa pagod, sa confusion. So, you know, if it doesn't offer peace, know that it's not from God. If it only gives you confusion, if it only gives you pain, huwag mo na siyang i-justify because it's not gonna get better. I know it's kind of harsh and parang ang killjoy, hindi hopeful, but we need the truth sometimes and the truth sometimes hurts.
Yeah, speaking the truth in love. Speaking of love, ang dami nagbigay sa atin ng dami nating generous gifters. Thank you so much, Ina Morata, King Morris, Prima Clara, Love Mayi, Actor Renal, Isabel Ra, 879, Athena Lucina, MJ9420, FS Jose, and Robint. Marami pong salamat. You are very, very generous.
Thank you. Much appreciated. And alam mo, Marian, most of the people I hear when it comes to love, they say, like, follow your heart. Listen to your heart. Pero alam niyo ba?
Hi, Ami. Hi, Trina. Another, yes.
This is another,
ano masasabi mo doon sa follow your heart?
Well, this is a, you might think this is another, like, killjoy opinion, but the heart is, yes, Athena, it's deceiving. The heart can be deceiving, you know, like we've mentioned kanina, feelings can be manipulated by our enemies to really parang screw us up. So don't just listen to your heart, or don't just follow to your heart, question it, talk to it, lecture it, you know, recite Bible verses to it if you have to. But yeah, if we don't really discern or really practice asking questions first before we make decisions, it's not going to lead to good things. Because if we just follow our impulses, those impulses aren't really rooted in healthy, rational, life-giving sources. Kaya nga sila impulses eh. Diba?
Yeah.
Sometimes we want, I know, parang an escape or parang quick fix for our loneliness or for the scars of our inner child, like kulang tayo sa pansin, sa alaga, sa love, and we just want other people to heal that in a jiffy, but that's not right. And you know, you said earlier, sometimes pwedeng 30% lang yung ma-fill up ni space ng partner mo, and that's okay, because even if you're in the right relationship and you expect the other person to give you 100%, that's also unfair to expect of another person to like answer all the problems in your life or within you. So it's also parang downplaying the richness of your life, kasi marami ka pang pwedeng malaman na ma-explore in life, and you shouldn't really rest your future or your happiness on a partner.
Yes, so true.
And for those who are trying to walk the walk of faith, ask yourself the question, will you still worship or will you still pray to God even if He doesn't give you a love life? Like, what?
Oh, wow, no? Grabe.
Will you still say, God, you owe me one? Will you be angry? Or I think that's one of the questions that when you get to answer it, you get to know where your surrender really is. Yun.
True. Tsaka one of the best advices I've ever received is, you are not your feelings. So kapag may nafe-feel ka na na anger or galit or super, ay anger or galit, pareho lang pala yan, kilig, sobrang kilig, you know, you can separate yourself from your feelings na, okay, these are my feelings, they are not me, and eventually you can make a better decision. You do not make yourself and your feelings one. Kasi separate siya from you. And it's so important also to, you know, take a step back and always ask ourselves, ano bang motivation ko? Ano bang intention ko for getting into this app or getting into this relationship? Malungkot lang ba ako? Kaya ako nandito? Naiingit lang ba ako sa may mga relationship? Sobrang na-heartbroken ba ako dun sa last ko na kailangan ko ng bagong relationship para matulungan ako maka-get over? We have to know our intentions. I know a girl na she met a guy na super rich, ganyan, and then they were immediately together. Tapos they came from really broken families and hindi pa sila nahi-heal from there. Tapos they got married after 4 months. During the time they were preparing for the wedding, hindi na-enjoy nung girl kasi alam niya talaga deep inside, she was just there to escape the horrors of her home. So, marami akong nalalaman na ganyang kwento na nagpakasal, nagpakalayo-layo para mag-escape ng horror ng kanilang sariling home. And then finally, when it was their wedding, it was such a grand wedding, pero buong umaga, suka lang siya ng suka. And her body was really rebelling against her decision. And then eventually, ngayon, they are now separated. She ended up also cheating on the guy. Halos zero sex life daw sila. Ay, sinabi ko talaga. So parang our intentions for being in a relationship is so important. And yun nga eh, we are made for more. We are made for a long-term kind of happiness. So let's not settle. I know it's not easy. Oh my gosh, it's not easy. It's not easy to be single. There are really moments of, buti pa siya. Nag-meet na sila, di ba? Pero I realized that, yun nga, when you have a relationship with the Lord,
He puts your desires in the right place.
Oh. Tapos the joy is constant. The joy is constant. Yeah.
And for those na single and minsan na napapaiyak nga kayo, like sinabi ni Marian, don't put yourselves in a position where it's convenient to crave things that are not for you. Parang, wag na kayo mag-scroll or like, look at people's timelines kung saan pwede nyo kumpara yung life nyo or kumpara yung status nyo. Like, don't put yourself in a position where you'll be tempted to feel bad about yourself. Like, that's the first guard. Parang, wag nyo nang dalhin yung sarili nyo in places where hindi naman kayo mapapabuti. And yeah, like with your story, I think one moral lesson is that if it doesn't really make you a better person, if it doesn't make you love God even more, if it doesn't make you fall in love with life, if that relationship doesn't grow you or make you want to celebrate the joys of living, parang, why are you in it? Diba?
Yeah. Tinan mo, si Bakeka, no? Nag-message siya, sabi niya, napapaiyak na lang talaga ako sa situation ko now.
Oh no, we're sending you virtual hugs.
Yes, we will be praying for you.
Yeah.
Hey, tsaka it's so, alam nyo, another thing is, di ba pag gutom ka, parang lahat masarap. Parang lahat in the menu, ay gusto ko yan, gusto ko yan, gusto ko yan. So it's the same thing when we are so hungry spiritually, emotionally. Parang lahat, it seems appealing. Pero yun nga, it could be deceiving. So I remember the wife of Bo Sanchez, she came from a failed relationship. And then she was single for a time, and every time she felt the loneliness, ang lagi lang niyang pinipray is, God, make me whole, make me whole. So that prayer also helps me. So it's important na we come into a relationship, not perfect, but we are healed, we are happy, we are whole. Kasi we really need healthy, happy, holy families now, more than ever.
Yeah, but time flies pala when you're having a very purposeful conversation. So we have 3-4 minutes left. Kung nagtataka kayo kung ba't ako nandito at bigla ko invite ni Marian, I just want you guys to know that Marian and I will be releasing a book soon, separate books. It will be entitled Love and Light. And in my book, I'll be discussing a lot about love, feeling forward, dreams, finding purpose, asking the meaning of life, everything else in between. So I hope that you look forward to that. And also, Marian's book, Lord, Bakit Wala Pa Siya?
Yes, Lord, I'm sure that they will receive a lot of wisdom from your Love and Light book, Zara. It really fits you. You're so full of love and full of light.
Thank you, Marian. You
had a taste of her wisdom tonight. So if you want more of that, make sure to grab a copy of her book. Yung libro ko naman, it sounds so frustrated. Lord, ano petsa na ba't wala pa siya? Siyempre, totoo naman yon, may frustration. Pero, it's really all about what God taught me in the season of being single, that it's possible to really be joyful, to be filled with purpose, and to magkaroon ng mga tamang dahilan para ma-inlove, para maiwasan ang mga boys and not real men.
True. So, amen.
Yes, kailangan ng mga babae ng boys, not real men. Huwag gisingin si Adan pagtulog pa siya. Kasi kung hindi, ikaw ang magpapalaki sa kanya. Mapapagod ka lang, maluloshang ka pa. Okay.
Yes, so, amen.
Yeah. Okay, so
guys, you can follow me on Instagram and Facebook at One Love and Light Co. So I post every day or like 4 times a week. So I hope to see you there as well.
I'm also on Instagram and I also have vlogs. It's my name, Marian Mencias, and I interview real men on my Facebook page. It's at Mencias Marian. So I also hope to see you there. And next time, our topic will be... Ay, wait lang, Zara. Do you have any other thing to... Huh? Ano yun?
May next time pa.
Ha? Ano no?
May next time pa tayo.
Yes, may next time pa kami. We are going to talk about emotional maturity in a relationship. Yang tataa. Ready ka na bang magka-relasyon? Yung totoo. Okay, so Zara, any final message to them or anything pa that you want to tell them about something that they can look forward to about your book?
Well, I just want to thank everyone for tuning in. Parang I feel like parang fated kami ni Marian to be in this live stream together and to be with all of you. It was such a short time, but I think it was a very fruitful and purposeful time. So I hope to see you on Instagram, Facebook, and hope you look forward to the new book as well. Yun.
Sobrang nag-enjoy. Thank you, Zara, for being here tonight and sharing your wisdom so generously to all of us. I learned a lot from you as well. And ano nga ba yung sasabihin ko? And thank you guys for joining us. Thank you for all our generous gifters. Salamat sa mga binigay nyo sa amin. Pati yung mga nagpahalu-halu dyan. Hindi pa kami ganun ka-familiar with Kumu. Yeah. Pero,
this is our first time, both of us.
Oh, this is our first time, so bear with us. Pero eventually, kami na magpapalaganap ng kabuti ng gifts. Okay, so there will be an upcoming show. Stay tuned for Mama Og's Pack Humor, which is coming up next. We hope that you learn something that will not only bless you for tonight, but for the rest of your life.
Remember, don't just follow your heart, talk to it. Talk to it and lecture
yes.
it. And thank you, everyone.
Girls, remember, you are far more precious than diamonds. Far more precious than diamonds. Have a life before you become a wife. So more next time. Thank you, guys. We hope you have a good night. Ina, thank you. Claire, thank you. Bakit parang medyo na Zara, hello, hello.
Nag-lag ng... Hello? Nag-lag ng slide.
Okay, guys. Thank you so much for joining us. Till next time again. See you next week.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye, Zara.
Bye, Marianne. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.